Hi everyone, very good morning to all of you. Now we are going to discuss the question number 17. It is all about resistance. What is the variation in resistance of a conductor? Resistance of a conductor varies and what factors it will depend, and how the question will be asked based on the concept of resistance. To understand all these things, we need to know the very first thing is what is the resistance of a conductor? Nothing but Ohm's law. So what is Ohm's law says is, Ohm's law says that for any conductor or conducting wire, the voltage and current both are proportional to each other. So that I equal to V by R or R equal to V by I. This is the resistance of the conductor. So resistance of the conductor. That is what the basic definition from Ohm's law. So any conductor means when you apply a potential difference, then there is a current flow, and the ratio of the potential difference you applied and the current flown, we call it as resistance. Nothing but an opposition developed to the charge flow. That is what resistance. Now such one conducting wire, when you consider, let's take the conducting wire of length L and cross-sectional area is A, then what is the resistance of the conducting wire? That is proportional to length, inversely proportional to area, then it will become rho L by A. So this is the resistance of the conductor. And here resistivity nothing but 1 by conductivity. So what we can say is property of the material, which depends only nature of the material. But resistance depends on dimensions also, like length and area. And area of the conductor means pi r square, cylindrical shape. So this is how the resistance of a wire depends. Now, there is also one more relation will come for the Ohm's law, like J equal to sigma E, where J is current by area and sigma is conductivity and E is electric field. That is nothing but potential difference by distance or length, potential difference per unit length. So based on these relations also, sometimes the question can be asked. So this is like another form of Ohm's law also, you can say. So based on these relations, question can be asked, direct formula based question. And here sometimes they will also add the current relation, like current in a conducting wire is NEA VD. That thing also they can ask you. Now, how resistance of a stretched wire changes? Means, if you consider a wire, let's take a wire of length L and cross-sectional area A, then the resistance is rho L by A. Now here, if you stretch the wire, after stretching, the length increases and the area decreases. Like let's take this is pi r dash square and the initial area is pi r square. Now as it is stretching, the volume remains constant. So volume remains constant means A into L equal to A dash into L dash. So that here the relation will come A by A dash equal to L dash by L. So initial resistance you consider R, final resistance you consider R dash, then R dash by R equal to L dash by L into A by A dash. Nothing but you can write A by A dash place, you can write it as L dash by L, so that it will become L dash by L whole square. Or in place of L dash by L, I can write it as A by A dash, so it will become A by A dash whole square. That means resistance is proportional to L square and inversely proportional to A square, or inversely proportional to fourth power of radius in case of stretching of a wire. So this way you can understand how the resistance of a wire changes on stretching. Now here you can, they can also ask question based on percentage change, like R is proportional to L square, means delta R by R into 100 equal to 2 into delta L by L into 100. Also it is inversely proportional to A square, so you can take it as 2 into delta A by A into 100, but it decreases with increase in area, or increases with decrease in area. Also here in terms of radius, 4 into delta R by R into 100. So they can also ask the question based on percentage change, like I have given examples, we'll see. Now sometime they will also ask question based on what is the variation in resistance with temperature. Let's take R naught comma rho naught R at 0 degree Celsius, resistance or resistivity, and RT and rho T, these are at another temperature, let's take T degree Celsius. Then the resistance at any temperature, that is RT equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha delta theta, and rho T equal to rho naught into 1 plus alpha delta theta. This is the variation in resistance or resistivity with temperature. That means as temperature increases, resistance or resistivity increases. So based on this relation also, sometimes they will ask the question. So just you have to understand the question and you have to collect the data, then you have to substitute in the equation. Let's see few examples based on whatever we have discussed. A current of 1 ampere is flowing through a copper wire of length 0.1 meter and cross section area. If the specific resistance of copper be, calculate the potential difference across the ends. So one is they have given as current. That is current is 1 ampere and length is 0.1 meter and cross sectional area is 1 into 10 power minus 6 meter square. And specific resistance, nothing but resistivity, that is 1.7 into 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. So calculate the potential difference, they are asking. So when you consider the potential difference, what is the formula? Potential difference V equal to I into R, and I into resistance is rho L by A. So I rho L by A, all the values they have given, then you can find it easily. Now determine the current density. They are also asking current density, that is current per area J. So as I said, sometime they will ask question based on this also. So determine the current density in the wire. Now, next thing is, all the edges of a block with parallel faces are unequal. All the edges of a block with parallel faces are unequal. Its longest edge is 4 times its shortest edge. Find the ratio of maximum to minimum resistance between parallel faces. See here, there is like a cuboid shape they are telling. So this is length, this is breadth, and this is height. Now they are telling its longest edge is 4 times its shortest edge. Let's take suppose this is the shortest one. So here L is 4 times B. Find the ratio of maximum to minimum resistance. Now maximum to minimum here, see, you have to apply the logic on your own. I'll explain you. The resistance of a wire is rho L by A. Now area should be minimum. Now here 3 areas are possible. One is L into H, another one is B into H, another one is B into L. These are the 3 areas possible. And now there are 3 different lengths are possible, like H, B, L. When you consider H is the length and the corresponding area is this one, like this. This is area, this top. How much? B into L. When you consider B is the length, then area will become H into L. When L is the length, then the area is B into H. Now resistance is proportional to L by A. So resistance is proportional to L by A. That means one is H by BL, another one is B by HL, and another one is L by BH. Now L is 4 times B. So L is 4 times B means here if you substitute, what is the answer we will get? It is C. L equal to 4B. 4B, right? L equal to 4B means H by 4B square, first one. Second one, L equal to 4B. Now B equal to L by 4. L equal to 4B means 1 by 4H. L equal to 4B means 4 by H. Now you need to compare these 3 values and you need to decide. So this way you compare and you decide which is greater or less. Or else in a simple way I will tell you, when you consider, the length should be longer and area should be lesser. In that case, this is the maximum one. And length should be lesser and area should be more. In that case, this is the minimum. Length should be minimum, area should be more. So the ratio of maximum to minimum they are asking. Then you can take the ratio and you can substitute L equal to 4B if needed. So that way you can find the ratio of maximum to minimum. Means here the question is, for a cuboid, you can find the resistance between any 2 parallel faces. There are 3 set of parallel faces. So across which you can find the resistance. So after finding, if you compare, then you will get one is maximum and one is minimum. Now a copper wire has a resistance of 10 ohm. So they have given the resistance value is 10 ohm and an area of cross section 1 millimeter square. So you can convert, that is 10 power minus 6 meter square. The potential difference of 10 volt exists across the wire. Calculate the drift speed of electrons If the number of electrons per cubic meter in copper is, that means number electron density is 8 × 10^28 per meter cube. Then what they are asking, drift speed. Now, here the potential difference equal to I into R resistance. Resistance is given, potential difference is given. And current equal to NEA VD into R. So the drift velocity VD equal to V by NEAR. V is given, A is given, N is given, R is given. E, small e is the charge of electron. So that way I already told you, like sometimes they will link the Ohm's law with current in an electric current relation, that is NEAVD in terms of drift velocity. So you have to just understand the question and collect the data and do the careful calculation without forgetting any conversion of units. Now, as we discuss the percentage change, so a copper wire is stretched to make it 0.1% longer. That means percentage change in length is 0.1%. Now then the percentage change in resistance, as R is proportional to L square, so according to our formula, delta R by R into 100 equal to 2 into delta L by L into 100. So that will become 2 into 0.1, that is 0.2%. So direct question they can ask means you have to remember that particular situation. You have to remember that particular relation, that in case of stretching, R is proportional to L square and R is inversely proportional to A square, or R is inversely proportional to R power 4 radius. Now, we also discussed about the effect of temperature on resistance. Resistance of a thin wire at one temperature is 20. The wire is placed in a liquid bath and its resistance rises to 1.2 ohm. What is the temperature of the bath? Alpha value they have given. Now first, R1 equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha T1 at one temperature. Now the resistance became R2 at another temperature. Let's take alpha T2. Now they have given T1 is 20 degrees Celsius and R1 is 1 ohm. Now they have given R2 is 1.2 ohm and T2 we don't know. But in both the cases, alpha value they have given as 3.8 × 10⁻³ per degree Celsius. Now here we don't know R0, resistance at 0 degree Celsius. Then what we can do here is, we can divide both of them. Like R1 by R2 equal to, now 1 plus alpha T1 plus 1 plus alpha T2. So that R0 cancel. Now if you cross multiply R1 plus R1 alpha T2 equal to R2 plus R2 alpha T2. Now they are asking T2. Sorry, this is T1, R2. Now you take T2 terms one side and then other terms other side, like R2 minus R1 plus R2 alpha T1 whole divided by R1 into alpha. So we have R1, R2, alpha, T1, all the values we have. Just substitute, then you will get it. So this is the way you can find the answer. And this is how the questions will be asked based on the resistance of a wire. What is the resistance of wire? What is Ohm's law? And what is current density? What is current in a conducting wire? And how the potential difference and current is related? And how the resistance of a wire changes on stretching, and how the resistance of a wire changes with the change in temperature. These are all the things they can ask you based on the concept of resistance of a conductor. And as usual, I have given 5 assignment based questions based on the same concept. Also NCRT. See, in NCRT, they have given 6 questions approximately. So you can understand the importance of this topic in NEET, entrance point of view. So please solve all the questions, and we'll meet in the next class with the next question. Thank you all of you.